Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. Welcome to part two of my little discussion of the three wonderful Revell pickup trucks. So, you know, when you're working with these, you sort of have to keep an open mind. And the fun, you'll have quite a bit of fun. Let me pull back here so you can see a little bit more. You know, as I said, any of these will bring you a great deal of fun, and they could be modified. You could build 100 of them and have every single one look different. You can modify the frame. You can modify the bed, as you saw previously with the 54 that I showed you. But here is here's the 37, and it's a little jiggly because I didn't glue it because I like to have access. But and here I'll take apart some of it for you, so you could see it. And again, another kit that just builds up so nice, you know. And you can have a blast building these. So, you know, this part, of course, is not completely glued, but oop, there goes the chain. As I said, I leave all the elements loose. I drilled out some holes on the chassis. Again, a scratch built the bed using real wood. The tank here is also scratch built. Watch parts. The engine, I didn't go as far as wiring it, but that's okay. Not every kit you build, not every model you build has to be super detailed for you to have fun and enjoy the process. So this is again one of my favorite truck kits because it's extremely versatile, and you can have a lot of fun doing it. You can add little details like an emblem here and there. I mean, you know, it's just and always be careful when you handle your models. So, you know, it's just it's a blast. It's a blast. And so the objective here with these videos is to show you that you know, whenever I and this is human nature, you know, you're sitting around saying, "Oh, I'm uninspired. I don't know what to build." You know, so I'm hoping these videos will get you fired up about perhaps building one of these in whatever form you want, whether it's shiny, a low rider, or a custom, two-tone, single paint, rusty, weathered, you name it. You know, here's another 37, okay? Again, had quite a bit of fun detailing the bed. The bed in this case is real wood. These planks are weathered and painted with a product that I love called Crackle Paint, and there are real cracks everywhere. If you look closely, you're not going to be able to see it on the video, but you know, just absolutely extremely realistic. And there's dirt glued on there, a brick that I made. It's just, you know, again, it's a lot of fun. This one, of course, is glued completely. So there's the chassis and a little chain here on the side. So you see the variety in these. You know, one of my signature touches is always to paint a panel as if it had been replaced. You could put graphics, you could do anything you want. The rusting is sort of subtled. I like to drill holes here and there, put wire, do all kinds of crazy stuff just to make it different and make it look like it's fun, and it is fun, and you will have a blast doing it. You know, and as I said, it's a great foundation. Any of these kids will make a great foundation for a rat rod, you know, rat rod truck, rat rod, hot rod, you name it. They all come with great decals and graphics, so you could use them on those cars or something else. So just, you know, keep them around. Here's the 41 Chevy, and again, it you know, it comes apart. See, you see the pattern now. All of these things, you know, basically I built like this because I like to have access. And sometimes it's that I know that I need to come back in and put more details, finish, you know. There's the engine, sort of one of the cleaner engines, you know, and one of the cleaner chassis. So again, don't feel like you have to. Everything doesn't have to be shiny all the time. Not everything has to be weathered all the time. And again, this is yet another kit that goes on together really, really well. Loose elements, a box, a Mexican blanket. And again, well, you get the point. And you see how easily and quickly these kits come together, you know. And you just have to remember that you didn't glue it, you know. Here's the graphics, you know, from another build and another kit. So, like I said, it's fun, and you will end up, you know, in that case, the interior of the 41, all of the interiors are detailed. And if you go over to the Fotki archive, you will see what I'm talking about. You know, I spend a lot of time and attention detailing the interiors, even though they're very hard to see. But when you go over to the Fotki archive, you will see that. In the coming days, I am going to make a how to visit Dr. Kranke's archives so that you could see what's there. Just a lot. I mean, it's a chronicle of my entire building career from the very beginning to now. So there's lots to see over there. So I hope when you visit the laboratory, then you also visit the archives. I hope you will find a lot of inspiration there. And I hope you find a video like this extremely useful. But I'm sure you'll let me know and you'll chime in with your comments and your observations. And my friends, the reason behind this kind of video is to really inspire you and to keep you building and trying different things. And again, all for selfish reasons, because I'm a styrene addict of the highest order, meaning that I have such a hunger for new work and for looking at what you're doing and the way you're doing it. That's what the hobby is all about. Sharing the styrene addiction, and keeping the community rich with a lot of eye candy. So anyway, I wish you all well, and please stay tuned in for more. The Kranke Show is full steam ahead. Until next time, Dr. Kranke here in the laboratory.